Shady's back, back. Tell a friend.
2 years after the Eminem Show, the most popular rapper in the world is back for an encore.
It feels so good to be back.
It's time to meet the new mature side of a man named Marshall Mathers.
To be the soldier who never blows his composure.
We sat down with Eminem for an exclusive interview about his latest multi-platinum album.
Hush, little baby, don't you cry.
And its four remarkable and very different videos.
Right now, lose it.
From Eminem's take on the King of Pop.
I was definitely surprised at Michael Jackson's reaction. The video wasn't to pass judgment or anything.
Strap him with an AK-47, let it go.
To his own brand of patriotism.
I don't have any problem with America itself, but at the same time, one man can f*** up.
I ain't trying to have none of my people heard or murdered.
From his feuds with some of the biggest names in hip-hop.
Toy Soldiers was a way for me to try to put an end to it before somebody gets hurt, killed, whatever.
Haley, I know you miss your mom, and I know you miss your dad.
To the one thing that gets him emotional, his family.
It's the first song that I ever wrote that made myself actually, you know, cry.
Here comes Eminem's ultimate encore. Whether he's going by Slim Shady, Marshall Mathers, or Eminem, one thing never changes. His music is all about him. Today, the defiant white boy from Detroit is one of the biggest selling hip-hop artists of all time. And he's still not afraid to piss you off. If you want to know the full story about how he got here, you first have to look back at where he came from. Eminem first rocked the mic as Dr. Dre's protege, Slim Shady, in January of 1999. My Name Is, the first single off of Eminem's debut album, the Slim Shady LP, instantly hooked a horde of disaffected kids.
Hi, kids. Do you like Primus?
Yeah,
wanna
yeah.
See me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids?
My Name Is was the second song that we came up with. Dre will tell you this, too. It was a sample, and he played it, and he was like, we could take this, and we could do this with it, we could do that with it. And I'm like, what? As soon as he started playing it, I was like, hi, my name is. Instantly came up with it, and it was crazy.
Stop the tape. This kid needs to be locked away.
Get him.
Dr. Dre, don't just stand there. Operate.
Thanks to Dre's mixing board genius and M's agile rhymes, the Slim Shady LP went multi-platinum in less than 3 months. Suddenly, Eminem was everywhere.
The winner is Eminem, My Name Is.
At the 99 MTV Video Music Awards, Eminem took home his first statue for Best New Artist in a Video.
I want to thank all the fans that made Slim Shady possible.
But M didn't take much time to polish his Moon Man.
May I have your attention, please?
Just 1 year after the Slim Shady LP, he released his follow-up, the Marshall Mathers LP.
I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you want is Slim Shady's adjustment on things.
The album's first single and video, The Real Slim Shady, lashed out at his critics.
You think I give a damn about a Grammy? Half of you critics can't even stomach you, let alone stand.
I say things to get a rise out of a lot of people, to catch them off guard or to piss them off, especially people who don't understand hip-hop and don't understand what it's about.
He didn't just say what I think he did he?
The Real Slim Shady's video was loaded with impersonations. Britney, Christina, Tommy Lee, and many more. If you were famous for being famous, you were probably going to get slammed.
I'm sick of you little girl and boy groups, all you do is annoy me, so I have been sitting here to destroy you.
I started making popular music, so it was like when I first started lashing out at pop stars, it was because I was placed in that category, and coming from being an underground MC, I just didn't want to be grouped in with that bunch.
Slim Shady's next single, The Way I Am, laid the smackdown on the media.
All of this controversy circles me, and it seems like the media immediately points a finger at me.
I love hip-hop, and if somebody is saying something about me, I gotta address it. I am whatever you say I am. If I wasn't, then why would you say I am?
In the paper, the news every day I am. Radio won't even play my tape.
After facing allegations that his music was homophobic and violent, and battling a $10 million defamation lawsuit from his mom, M struck back at the 2000 VMAs.
And the winner is Eminem!
That night, Eminem took home the Best New Artist in a Video Award and thumbed his nose at his haters.
Every time that, like, a relative sues me, every time a critic tries to slam me in the press or whatever, I really want to thank you people for making my record as big as it is. Thank you.
I'd like to welcome you.
y'all to the Eminem Show.
2 years later, Eminem completed his hip-hop trilogy when he released The Eminem Show in May of 2002.
I'm cleaning out my closet.
Marshall Mathers opened his closet to the world, revealing his troubled childhood, including some major issues with his mom.
But how dare you try to take what you didn't help me to get? You selfish bitch, I hope you burn in hell for this.
I watched everyday life, everyday living, and what my mother was doing, you know, and just started to write about that. I'll be honest, it was bad.
I never meant to make you cry, but tonight I'm cleaning out my closet. Lose yourself in the music.
Later that year, Eminem turned Hollywood on its ear when he starred in 8 Mile. The movie, along with the video for Lose Yourself, showed us how a dirt poor kid from Detroit became Eminem.
His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy, there's vomit on his sweater already, mom's spaghetti.
Well, I've had a lot of stuff happen in my life that not everybody knows about, that I can't tell everything in my music. So, you know, there's some instances that have taken out of my life, and there's some that are completely fictional, just made up.
Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity, oh, there goes gravity, choke.
The film grossed over $116 million at the box office and won an Oscar for Best Original Song. The video for Lose Yourself helped sell over 4 million copies of the 8 Mile soundtrack. Like Dre before him, Eminem has now become a hip-hop mentor and producer, kickstarting the careers of 50 Cent and his crew, G-Unit. After conquering both the music and film industries, Eminem returned to Spit Rhymes in November of 2004 with Encore. We got a chance to sit down with the man himself for an exclusive chat about the four very different videos from his latest album and his always evolving career and personal life.
Well, congratulations on your latest record.
Thank you.
Congratulations on the success as well. From a video perspective, when do you start thinking about the videos? Is it when the singles start coming up one at a time?
The best way to go about it is to not really think about your first single. I concentrate on making the best songs that I can. When I get about 10, 15 songs, then I start looking for that single. A lot of times it's kind of funny because it's usually the last song that we make for the record. You're taking like a solid year straight to make an album. And by that time, you're just so slap happy that the first thing that comes to mind, you ain't afraid to let it go. And that's how Just Lose It came about.
Guess who's back, back again, yeah. Shady's back, tell a friend.
The first video off this record, Just Lose It, you've got the humor, you've got the kids, you've got the club, and then of course you have the characters. How did you select the specific people to mock, if you will?
It was deliberately up that alley of impersonating, you know, icons from the 80s. I kind of learned dance steps and whatnot from watching MC Hammer videos.
Everyone report to the dance floor, to the dance floor.
Yeah, I wear a cone and dress up as Madonna. I don't know if everybody's gonna remember Pee Wee Herman. No disrespect, Pee Wee, because I remember you. The Pepsi commercial. Michael Jackson's hair catching on fire.
All right, now lose it. Just lose it. Go crazy. Oh, baby. Oh, baby.
And were you surprised at the reaction from Michael Jackson to the representation of his image in the song and in the video?
Yeah, I was definitely surprised at Michael Jackson's reaction. The video wasn't to pass judgment on anything.
What else could I possibly do to make noise? I done touched on everything but little boys.
You know, he may have felt like he got it the worst because of what he's going through or whatever, but that wasn't the ultimate intention was, let's get Michael Jackson right now.
That's not a stab at Michael, that's just a metaphor, I'm just psycho.
His response is to say he respects you as an artist, and he himself as an artist wouldn't do that, wouldn't portray someone in that kind of light.
But parodies have been the jump start of my career, what launched me with How My Name Is. You're playing characters.
I'm gonna make you dance, get your chance.
You know, Weird Al Yankovic did it. I didn't hear no flack from that. In the third verse, when I break the rap down, I'm even making fun of myself.
Everything looks like it's 8 Mile now. The beat goes back and everybody lose the sound.
I was wondering if, whether you say to yourself, why do I always do this? Like, why do I come up with these big ideas?
Oh, my God. The song was about losing it. And towards the end of the video, I've lost it so much that I'm butt naked, you know, running down the street.
They say I was running butt naked down the street screaming, ah!
Eric Estrada pulls me over and gives me a ticket. I don't know how you arrest a man naked. I know what I'm doing, and I know my job is to not only just to rap, but to entertain people. And that's what videos are about.
All right, now lose it.
growing up.
I exercise my right to express when I feel it's time.
I spoke my mind and I stood up for what I believed in, and at least said it, at least put it out there.
I heard him say Haley's name on the song and I just lost it.
When people start throwing your kids into the battle, it becomes like, who can throw the lowest blow?